drop a like in the video in the next 5 seconds, and you will join DF in NBA 2K21. Trust me, it is worth it. One of the best builds in the game. The build that I went on the world record win streak with. The build that I won jackpot with. The build that I got to 10,000 wins with. The build that you have all been waiting for. Well, today is the day. Today, I will be teaching you guys exactly how to make this build step by step. The build that is at a tall height at 6'8", with almost max wingspan, Hall of Fame playmaking badges, while having the ability to speed boost, get reverse dunks, equip the overpowered hop steps, and get sharp takeover. Stay tuned to get this new glitchy build in NBA 2K20.
I was just down bad last week, now they won't come around. Remember rolling splits of sour, we was smoking pounds. On the app, that shit was daily, shit got lonely now. It's funny how they talk about me when I'm not around. See on my back, it is a target, gotta watch my life. Thinking twice when I step out the crib, they want my life. Remember while he died.
What is good, YouTube? It's your boy Henry, aka Double H DF, and I'm back in the building with yet another banger. Logo Double H in this one, you know the vibes. But anyways, I'm gonna be showing you guys how to make my new demigod build that all of you guys have been asking for in my comment section and in my stream. So make sure you guys drop a like on the video, subscribe to the channel if you guys are new, and turn on post notifications so you see me go live with this build. I also stream on Twitch every single night. But anyways, why should you listen to me? Well, I have over 10,000 wins on this game, about a 90-91 win percent, a lot of stage experience too, so I obviously know what it takes to win in this game. I've used a lot of builds throughout the year, so I know what builds may be good, what builds may be bad, and which ones you should be using on which court, like ones, twos, and threes, and what badges to use with that build as well. I also am the number one rep in NBA 2K20, and I was the 7th legend in NBA 2K20, so I know have a lot of experience with a lot of different builds and a lot of experience with playing a lot of different. So in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys the best badges for this build, whether you're a legend or not a legend, the best badges for to use with this build for the ones, twos, and threes court, the best animations, dribble moves, signature styles, dunk packages, layup packages, all that good stuff for this build, and really just step by step exactly how to make this build and why it's such an overpowered, underrated build. So let's just hop straight into it. I'm not going to waste y'all time. Let's first look into how to make this build. Okay, so here we are in the build creator. Now first, the position I went with, small forward. This is the position where I get the most badges from, and it's where I get, you know, the right height at, because at point guard and shooting guard, you know, there's limitations to the height, but small forward also gives the most badges. Anyways, left or right hand doesn't matter. The pie chart, I went with pure yellow, so the yellow pie chart, I'll be getting Hall of Fame playmaking badges. Those are gonna be very useful, and this also gives me the ability to get certain takeovers that I want. Now, when it comes to the physical pie chart, there's a lot of good pie charts like the speed and the vertical that look good, but you have to go with the full speed pie chart, which is the highest one, so you are able to speed boost with this build. I wanted to go like very consistent with each attribute. I wanted to be able to do everything with this build. So with finishing, a maxed out driving dunk, layup, close shot, and a little of post hook so I can get that 10 finishing. Same with shooting, I maxed everything out until I got to 10 and then I stopped upgrading. Playmaking, I had to get that pass accuracy to an 81 and max the ball handle. I need the ball handle, and I got the 17 playmaking badges. And then my defense, I also wanted to get to as close as 10 as possible with the upgrades that I had left. So I upgraded everything except for offensive rebound. I upgraded just a little bit, not too much, and I got 9 defensive badges. Now look at how spread out this is. I have 10 finishing, 10 shooting, 9 defense, and 17 playmaking. Now as you can see, if I go down the list of my attributes and take one away, I lose a badge. This is how you know you've maxed out your build and used your attributes to the best of their abilities. Okay, this is literally perfect. Now it comes to the body shape, I went with compact. You can really go with anything. I just like how compact looks. I think it's a nice in between. Height, I'm going with 6'8". Okay, 6'9 is too tall, you're gonna be too slow. 6'7, I want to be taller than that, so I went 6'8". Now when it goes to weight, you may as well go 187 because you can get that extra plus one of the strength without taking away from anything else. And then when it comes to wingspan, you don't want to go too high because you can't go lower than a 77 ball handle, because when you hit 99, you're going to get that plus 5 boost and you want at least an 82 ball handle. So I went with 85.8, and look at these takeovers. Don't pick slashing takeover. You don't get contact dunks. Sharp is better than shot creating. Playmaking, we're already basically a pure playmaker. Sharp takeover makes this build so much more glitchy. Oh my god, the shooting on this build is crazy with sharp takeover. So I went with that, and it's called a facilitating finisher. Now this game is so bad because you could literally make a facilitating finisher like 11 different ways. People tell me, oh, you made this YouTuber's build or this YouTuber's build just because my name is a facilitating finisher, when really nobody really has this build. This is a build I just made by myself. It's just called a facilitating finisher, which doesn't make too much sense. Anyways, here are the badges for this build. Now, I am a legend, so I do get plus 10 badges. I'm going to be showing you guys the best badges to use with and without legend, okay? So, without legend, these are the finishing badges I would go with, okay? You got gold fancy, gold slayer, gold contact, bronze acrobat. Very consistent finishing setup right there. This works for every court, 1s, 2s, and 3s. Now, when it comes to shooting, gold quick draw, gold ranger center, silver deadeye, and silver green machine are the most needed. There's a lot of other good finishing or shooting badges like hot zone hunter, catch and shoot, all that stuff, but those are the most important ones. Playmaking badges, these are the ones I went with. Once again, there's a lot of other good playmaking badges, but these are just the best available, okay? Bronze bailout, very useful as well. When it comes to defensive badges, we're going with gold clamps, gold intimidator, bronze interceptor, and silver rim protector. This is the perfect setup. You only need bronze interceptor to steal lane passes, so that's why I went with that. Now, when it comes to badges with legend, this is what I run. Now, these are the badges I run on the 1s, 2s, and 3s right here for my finishing. Very overpowered. I can actually drop step guards very well considering I am 6'8". And these are the shooting badges where I went with gold difficult shots. Is so overpowered, especially with takeover. This is the badges I run with on every single court. And then when it comes to the playmaking badges, obviously I would take off floor general diamond bailout and put it on tight handles, post spin, and stop and go if I was on the ones. But these are the badges I run on the 2s and the 3s. I break a lot of ankles with those badges. And here are the defensive badges. Now, if I was on the 1s, I would take off interceptor and chase down and put on moving truck and post move lockdown. Now, once again, you can switch between tireless defender, pickpocket, and pick dodger, but that's up to you. But these are the badges I recommend, and these are the badges I use. You could use a different setup, but these are the ones that I use and prefer using. Now, before we get into the animations, the drill moves, the signature styles, the dunk packages, and all that good stuff, I'm going to be showing you guys the build at 99 overall. So here it is. This is the build at 99.9. So all my attributes go up plus 5. Because as you guys know, after you hit 95 and you hit 96, 97, 98, 99, 99.9, you get a plus 1 for each of those overalls. So I get plus 5 to all my attributes. And here's what it looking like. The driving is looking very good. That post look is actually pretty high for a small forward playmaker. I also have 79 driving dunks, so I can unlock those reverse dunks and a couple other good dunk packages. 84 driving layup, very good. I have a 76 three-pointer and an 82 mid-range plus the sharp takeover. That is going to be a lot and definitely enough to shoot literally any shot on the court. 82 ball handle, I'll be able to speed boost before I even get to takeover, but not off rip. 86 pass accuracy, plenty to throw any kind of passes, especially with bailout on. And now the defensive attributes, the rebounding is looking very nice for at least the defensive side, but everything else is looking pretty decent, except the lateral quickness, perimeter, and steal is looking a little sus, but I'm going to be showing you guys why you shouldn't pay attention to those defensive attributes and why my size actually makes my defense so good. I'm going to be showing you guys some gameplay later, but yeah, here are the attributes. 93 speed, 93 acceleration, 73 vertical, 99 stamina. This build is very fast. You got to remember, I'm 6'8", almost max wingspan, so these attributes are absolutely ridiculous for my size. So now I'm going to be showing you guys all the animations and all that good stuff. So first off, here is my jump shot. My jump shot is pure Dante Exum. I don't have custom jump shots, so it's just Dante Exum. I'm using dribble pull-up normal 4, so that's my fadeaway, spin jumper Stephen Curry, hop jumper normal 14, which goes along with my hop steps, and everything else is default. Going on to my dribble moves, my dribble style is Kawhi Leonard, which is how high I dribble the ball. Size of package is Kobe Bryant. These are the couple moves that gives me you know, that big step back. It gives me the between the legs, and it also gives me that little moving crossover right there. And then moving crossover is normal 1. Everybody should be using that. Pro behind the back is pro 6. This is how I get back to the 3-point line on this move right here. And I can get up the court really fast if I'm on the 3s using this move as well. Moving spin, this is how I do my spin backs with pro 4. You can also use basic 1. That's another good spin back as well. Moving hesitation, we have pro 8. This one is super good for players that can't speed boost off rip because it is very easy to fake out your opponent with that hesitation. And triple threat style WNBA 2. Dunk packages, I have long athlete. That gives me the long Hop steps, rim grazes off one, never gets blocked. Baseline reverses off two. This is the only reverse dunk I could get, but it'll have to do. Front clutches is also another dunk that never gets blocked. After that, I basically have like a couple alley-oop animations like this one. I equip that so I can catch alley-oops a lot, and I'm 6'8", and trust me, it works very well. I don't get any contact dunks. So the other thing I could possibly show is, oh yeah, take off your park layup animations as well. Make sure those are off. Because you'd be getting blocked on those a lot. The only park dunk I'd be using is game time. And then in-game celebrations, my green light animation. I really use any of these. I think the best ones are peekaboo, walking on the moon, and mic drop. But that's about it for the animations. Now here are just a few clips so you guys can see this build in action. This build is very fast with the dribbling and can really shoot some crazy shots and break ankles, as you can see with Space Creator. I mean, look at, I'm literally fading off my back leg, still making that. Like I said, the spin back on this player is dirty. Make sure you put on that basic or that pro 4 or that basic 1. The behind the back is godlike too. I'm telling y'all, bro, this build is different. Look at me shooting lightlies with no steady shooter, because this takeover is so godlike. The reverse dunks at 6'8", I mean, you can literally just spam that and go crazy with it. Okay, and look at how fast the shooting is. You didn't think gold quick draw was a fast enough? I literally shot that in 1 second. Like, come on now. This is a 7-3 center contesting me. I'm still shooting over him. I'm basically a stretch big, okay? Look at how deep I'm shooting too with goal range extender. Like, I don't think y'all get it. Look at it. Fading into three people, bro. When I tell you this takeover makes this build a sharpshooter, I'm like, look at this shot right here. Like, bro, are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Like, come on now, bro. And these aren't just clips. You can see me stream on Twitch, on YouTube to watch this build. Like, I do this shit on the regular, okay? And look at the clamps too. You, like I said, he might not have the lateral quickness, but this, the frame of this build, the wingspan of this build, this height of this build, like, look at the, if you, you know a build is good at defense if he's getting those block animations. But anyways, I'm gonna show you guys two different gameplays. One of the games, which is this one, I'm just going to force layups the entire time, okay? Now, most of the time, guards are going to be guarding me, okay? Because I'm going to be, you know, the main ball handler. So, if I'm 6'8", most other guards are 6'4", 6'5". Like, bro, that's way too short to guard this player. This dude knows every possession that I'm driving, and I am just going to force the drive. I have the overpowered hop steps. I have reverse dunks. I have a 79 driving layup. Like, it is way too open. The driving on this build for no Hall of Fame driving badges and no, you know, driving in the pie chart is actually ridiculous. The size and the wingspan of this build and the with the right dunk packages is almost unstoppable. I mean, look at me, bro. And even if I miss, look at, I'm getting that board most of the time, okay? Like, I put on bronze, you know, silver rebound chaser. I'm getting that board every time. Look at, and one, like, that's literally ridiculous. I forced a drive on this dude every possession and went 11 for 12. Like, if that's, like, come on, bro. Now, this game right here, I'm going to be forcing a three every single possession. So, if you didn't think this build could shoot, trust me, this build can shoot big greens. Now, another thing is with sharp takeover, the more your takeover goes up, like, the higher your three-point rating actually goes up. So, you don't need takeover for your shooting just to boost. Like, once you know, the takeover meter starts going up, the easier it is to shoot, which is really overpowered with this sharp takeover. I mean, look at me, bro. I have, look at how many open layups I have, even right here. Like, I'm just gonna shoot a three every time, and there's nothing this dude can do about it. I'm too tall. I can literally shoot over these guards, and I'm fast as heck because I have Hall of Fame playmaking badges, and I mean, I really am a pure playmaker. So if you think these clips aren't consistent and then I'm just grabbing these clips out, trust me, subscribe to the channel, turn on post notifications so you see when I go live on YouTube. Follow me on Twitch, I go live on there every single night. And I mean, did I not just go on a 130 game win streak, 129 game win streak? If that's not consistency, I don't know what is. I literally went on a 129 game win streak with this build. Link will be in the description to that video. It's my last video I just posted. Go watch me go crazy with this build if you want to see some more gameplay. But anyways, guys, if you enjoy this video, if this build helped you out at all, make sure to drop a like on the video right now. Subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. 200,000 subscribers on the way. Like I said, follow me on Twitch. Come to my streams if you want to see this player go crazy, or go watch the last win streak video. I went on 129 game win streak on the 1v1 core. Like I said, this build can go crazy on the ones, the twos, the threes. But anyways, hopefully this video helped you guys out. It's been your boy Henry, aka Double HDF, man. And I'm out, y'all. Peace.